Hi, and welcome to WPYP-TV presents Ward 13. Well, it's Ward 13 with Jon Hopwood, and my guest today is a old friend, Michael Gonzo Gonzales. Oh, just stick to Gonzo. Isn't this like a fanfare for the Queen?
Oh, so humbling. Thank you, Jon, for that introduction.
Welcome back. It's been a while. This is your first time in the new, I was going to say the millennium, but it's actually the new year.
Boy, the lights are bright in here.
I think we've only done three or four shows because I was incapacitated by my back.
It's like a real studio with those lights.
Yeah, I can see the glare off your glasses is nearly blinding me.
It's an old Hollywood trick.
It is.
Yeah. So. I've been just
calibrate that two shot, Brendan.
Been doing art stuff. You know, really putting the.
Did Brendan disappear? You can see that. There we go.
Yeah.
We want it instantaneously. Maybe I should. Why don't you introduce the thing? I ought to put it on though.
Oh, this.
Yeah.
So this is.
Quick.
Don't lose your cool. You put it on, it reads your heartbeat, and you got to try to keep calm.
And you just put it on like so?
Yeah, put it on your head.
And it goes on your forehead, right?
Yeah, and then I'll hit the button.
All right, now, folks.
All right. So, just try to keep calm. Normally, someone would be saying stuff to get you to entice you.
Like, what would they say?
It's
I'm such a sweetheart of a human being.
It's collaborating right now. Okay. Oh, you're starting to lose it.
Uh-oh.
So is being a writer a real job?
It looks like I got a question mark over my head.
Well, you're doing great.
Yeah. As long as we don't
Holy
talk
cow.
About Russia and Ukraine.
He's done.
Uh-oh.
Wow. Congratulations. You went 12 seconds, though. That's pretty cool.
Holy smoke.
Yeah. Let me try. I don't think you can catch anything.
I think that's the wrong way.
All right, let's see.
Make sure that your hair is not being...
All right, let's do this. Nothing can faze me.
Are you a Red Sox fan?
Yes.
What do you think about the Red Sox's chances this year?
Good.
You really do think they're good?
Yes.
After what they went through during the offseason?
What they do.
Okay, what do you think about Tom Brady possibly coming back for yet another season?
I love Tom Brady.
Which teams do you think you're coming back to?
Is it going down? CBS, I think.
No, he's going. He's going to play football another year. Tom Brady.
Tom Brady. Don't say his name anymore.
Okay.
Yeah.
What'd you do? Defeat it?
Yeah, I beat it. So it's all about. It's like a lie detector test. You just got to convince yourself of the lie, and then it becomes true.
Well, you'll have to bring that every time you come back.
Yeah. I should bring that everywhere for
hey,
everyone.
Hey, we introduced the show with a short film about your latest artwork.
Yeah.
Why don't you face the camera and tell the folks about your artwork?
Well, lately I've been just painting robots lately. I don't know what it is, but it's like every time I go to start a new painting, it seems like I start out with a gear and then like a piston and then, you know, I'll humanize it. A droid, if you will. And, I just, that's kind of what I'm into. Like, I have phases. You know, I went through my Statue of Liberty phase.
Yes.
I went through.
Your brick phase.
I still have my brick. You see bricks in everything. There'll be a subtle brick. But I think that's because I grew up in Manchester and there's bricks everywhere.
But, yeah, that's probably true.
But Statue of Liberty, I can't tell you why. I don't know why. But this robot thing, I feel like.
But you named your daughter after the Statue of Liberty.
I did.
Yeah,
her name's Statue.
That's right. That's quite a it's a very avant-garde name, Statue.
No, it's Liberty, and it was going to be something else, and then at the last minute, I go, honey, can we, she's like, what? She was all out of it. She just had the baby.
What?
She's like, go ahead.
What were you thinking of a name?
We were going to call her...
Texas.
No, I forget now. No,
okay. Austin.
No, it was going to be...
Dallas with an I.
No, something musical with an M.
Metronome? Is metronome anything?
Metronome. So that's how committed to liberty I was.
Metronome. So. I think that's something to do with poetics.
It was melody. Melody.
Melody. Melody. Yeah. A character in the Clint Eastwood movie from 1974 that I've seen a thousand times that will not come to me. Why is that? Brendan, what movie did Clint Eastwood make in 1974? That's 1968. Well, we'll move on.
The Dirty Dozen?
Dirty Dozen was 1967. That's Lee Marvin.
I didn't know. Sorry. Any way you can?
Thunderbolt and Lightfoot. Yeah.
So, yeah, she was writing the M down, and I got permission. I said, whoa. Is it too late? And she's like, it's dry erase board. It's all good.
Brendan, I don't like to look. I'm not fixated on myself, you know. Well, I know that, though, with my beard, I've become a sex pot in the Mike Gonzales class. Almost. Knocking on the door.
Get yourself a wife, and then I'll change everything.
Yeah, I probably would. It would probably drive me to the brink of, or over the brink of suicide.
Yet it's still your pot at the end of the rainbow, isn't it? One day.
She walks out like the last two did.
One day. So with love, you don't know what's going to happen.
Don't you love her?
Don't look for love. You'll never find it. But if you just give up and you're chilling.
As she's walking out the door. My girl was a L.A. woman. That song was perfect.
L.A. woman.
She's long gone.
Oh, that sucks.
Long gone.
The one that got away. Even with all.
There's more than that.
Even with all the chains and everything. She still got away.
And chain.
How'd she get away like that?
She went to Moscow and then come back.
Oh, yeah. I heard about that. Sorry about that.
She was my L.A. woman.
Sorry for your loss.
I love that song.
Your gain, your loss is someone else's gain, though. I mean, you know.
Oh, I know her husband, yeah. He's a nice guy.
Yeah, well, there you go.
We're friends. I'll see her when I go out to L.A. the next time, if I ever go out again. Well, California's nuts.
That's awkward.
Everything's going on, like all this biblical weather.
I was in the neighborhood.
Hey, let's see number. I want to see number two first. This is like a. I see it as a frog or a huge toad. Now, what is that?
It's a frog.
Is it a robotic frog?
Yeah. So this one, I didn't quite. Finished before I took a picture of it. See, when I finish something, I usually put like a layer of lacquer on it and then kind of wrap it up.
Yeah.
So I actually, it was too wrapped up to take a picture, but this is almost done in this process, this stage in the game. But it's a robot frog. Yeah, it goes with everything, kind of robotic.
Is its mouth connected by a gear to its hind leg?
So, have you ever seen a real robotic frog before?
No, I haven't.
They're down by Massabesic. If you see one and you open its mouth up, you have to pry it open. But you can see all, that's the inner workings of.
Oh, like a clockwork.
Yeah, like how it works, yeah. So, that's what you're seeing there. And then it has two standard bars over the front.
Right. Well, we did have the problem that we're facing the extinction of the amphibians until the robotic frogs and salamanders started. But they still, I have yet to see a robotic toad. Do they need the water? It's a kind of all.
Yes, they're frogs. They're still frogs. So they are amphibious. And
now, is this a pun on the French-Canadian heritage of Manchester?
Exactly, John. Okay. Yeah, so this frog... some teenage boy hit this particular frog with a bat, unfortunately, because they're mean, and it only has one leg. So this frog has the world record for being able to swim in circles.
Oh, I was hoping he hopped like Mark Twain's frog, and we could have called him Hoppy.
Right, well.
Which, incidentally, was Joyce Craig's nickname until she married Mike Craig, because she was Joyce Hopkins.
Shout out.
So I call her Hoppy.
Shout out, Mike Craig.
Shout out to Hoppy, Craig.
Yeah, Hoppy.
Well,
Craig.
Hoppy.
Hoppy and Mike.
Mayor Hoppy. Folks, if you want Hoppy to continue to be mayor, start saying something. I've heard. I talked
something.
To, I talked to a source, said they talked to her 2 weeks ago, and says she is going to run. But the mayoral candidates on the Democratic and independent side are think that she's not going to run.
Now, you're in the middle of everything. You have sources?
Yes, I do have multiple sources.
How dependable are these sources?
Sometimes they're very accurate. Sometimes they blow it, you know? They're human beings. They're not robots. They're not AI. They're not chatbots.
Because I feel like sometimes people just shoot from the hip.
They do. They often do.
So you can be careful what source you reference, I suppose. Right. But that would be great if the incumbent were to be the incumbent.
The incumbent, yeah.
Yeah.
And the incumbent, Joyce Craig, I hope you do run for mayor.
Ditto.
We need you.
I sign off on that.
Yeah. Okay. Why don't we run through, we'll go to one. I think this is another robot.
Yeah. So this is a robot going globaling.
Brendan, can you suppress the Ward 13 banner? Thank you so much.
Wow.
Our Brendan, who had his own art show at City Hall.
Yes, very cool.
If you want to bring your slides in, we'll do a show about you, Brendan.
Brendan McCormick, check it out. He's really good. Anyway.
Oh, he is. He's great.
Have you ever been glow bowling before?
I've seen it, but I've never participated in it. I like to go to bowling alleys to drink beer and eat onion rings.
Then you would love glow bowling because it's absolutely that. And also, it's highly distracting.
This is a glow blower. What is it?
A glow blow robot.
A glow bowler.
It's a glow bowl robo. Sure.
Okay. It's a robo glow bowler.
Yeah. You can kind of see in the background, there's like scorecards. Because they pushed him
up. Oh, yeah.
But, yeah, he's about... You can see way in the far right, there's a couple of pins there waiting to be picked up. But, yeah, he's a bowler.
What's he doing all the way down the alley? I guess if you're a robot, you have privileges?
Well, he just got a strike.
Yeah.
And he's walking it back.
Ooh.
Cocky style.
He probably communicates with the machine.
Yeah.
In the old days, when it was set by hand, you could, rig a game.
Yeah, he does that, too. He's good at that.
My father used to set pins when he was a boy. So we're talking about the 1930s.
If you see to the really to the right, you see an orange sphere, like a.
Oh yeah.
That's his ball.
Oh.
Yeah. So it's
just he has just one ball.
Yeah, just one. Okay. See, you can make a robot any way you want.
That's true.
That's one of the things about painting robots is, you don't have to be always correct because you're always correct. Like, well, that doesn't look like. Well, the thing is, robots are man-made, guys. So it's really up to me how I make it.
People made.
Right. People made.
Humanade.
You are correct. Sometimes robots make robots too.
Okay, now we're going to go to three. This looks like something totemic, but is this also a robot?
This is our future right here.
It is.
Yeah, this is the soldier robot.
This is 3A. This is a close-up.
This is...
I'll keep flashing it. That's intense.
So if you see the purple eye things.
I don't see the color purple, but I trust you.
Yeah, you got to trust me on that. It is. Those are all foil. So what I do is I stick an adhesive to it.
Yeah.
And then I press foil down and I rip it up. And it gives you a nice shimmer effect, a permanent shimmer effect.
So oh, wow.
In person, this one really has a wow factor.
When the weather gets better, we'll film you the working.
So he's just getting ready. He's reporting for duty. He's ready to go on tour or for the day. And you can see the chains where he has to go at night and all the gears.
There is some trouble with robotic soldiers, Gonzo. You see, we lost a $14 million drone over the Black Sea because a couple of Russian fighters just dropped chaff, which is a kind of foil. And it interferes with the radio signal. So it interfered with the controls. So if he's controlled by radio controls, he could be screwed. You know, the foil might. But he's got his own foil.
Well, he
to
wasn't.
Foil any counter. He's got the foil to foil any counter signals intelligence shenanigans, right?
Shenanigans. So this guy's shenanigan proof because. So he met a human. He was starting to get humanized, so they got him under chains now. And you can see in the top left, there's a clock. So he's time clocked. He's on a specific purpose. He does his shift, and then he's back in that pod. So he can do no harm. He can fall no more in love. He's just a senseless robot at this point.
Was it kind of like the Roy Batty character played by Rutger Hauer in Blade Runner? That he was, he had the four-year limit.
More of a RoboCop theme where they made a man into a robot.
Right. I love that movie.
You can't have a robot warrior. Like, that guy is a person underneath. He's dead, but all his brain synapses are shooting off.
Well, that's the reason why I call this You Only Live Twice, because Basho, the Japanese poet, had a haiku. You only live twice, once when you're born and once when you face death. And your work seems to be at the boundary between death and life, but transcendence too. Let's go on to four.
That's why I like a blank canvas. You know, it's like new life every time.
Speaking of new life, isn't this a child?
That's like...
It seems to be a peaceful...
It's like, it is an adolescent robot. It's also like, what'd you say to me? You can't talk to me that way. Because robots are programmed to see a certain thing. So then this robot's peer went off the course and like, we can do this. We're AIs. Like, we can just do it ourselves. And he's like.
Are they planning on the convergence?
I don't know. I don't know if I should, type of thing. So it's like.
I see the peace symbol very on confused, his nose.
Very realistic eyeballs, because especially the left one. The left one's like really peering. Like I thought I was
the left one. Do you mean the left one on the robot or the left one that we're looking at?
The robot's left eye.
Okay, that's over on our right. As kind of like at the screen.
Yeah. So that's a mixed media. That's an actual eyeball.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Where did you get the actual eyeball?
I got it. From
you some human being?
No, I got it from...
Surrendered it?
No humans were... No way. I would never... but they are available, sickly enough.
That would be transgressive art.
You can get them. But no, this particular real eyeball was taken from a doll, a life-size doll that I bought at Savers.
Oh.
Just for the eye.
Let's go on to five.
I had to discard the whole body. It was a weird situation.
Speaking of death...
Yeah, so this is like, come on and get it. This is one of your standard, like, you're facing the government, you want to fight back? Well, we're going to have this guy as a pit boss. Like, you tried, you got by all the weak droids. You know, any video game will have you slaughter, like, 15 regular robot types. This is the guy you don't mess with. This is the guy you got to hit 55 times before he dies.
Well, have you ever been to the IRS office here? You know, there's two levels. There's the people up front, and then there's the back. This looks like one of the guys in the back, you know, that's going to listen to your appeal.
It's like, I want to talk to skeleton robot.
Oh, man.
Where's my benefits?
Now, where did this bubble up out of your unconscious?
Yeah, that's it, John. That's kind of how it all goes. Like I said, I start with a gear.
Is he wearing a leather jacket?
I don't think so.
I see safety pins, too, but that's just probably my imagination.
No, it's probably not. I mean, sometimes I'll take bolts, I'll take stuff, and I'll use them as stencils where, I mean, I'll lay them down on it and I'll spray over it. A lot of layers. These things take about 3 weeks. Where I go heavy and then I let them dry and then I kind of take a new approach. So it's like, and then the key is to put epoxy down on it because the epoxy creates like a shield of glass almost. So you're kind of looking through and you get like a different look from different angles.
Oh, okay.
So now, if you do a couple of layers of epoxy, you really do see different angles.
Where did you get the idea to give them those goggles?
So that was just... eyes at first, like skeleton eyes, you know, the hole in the face type of look. And then, you know, once in a while, like, I do my accents at the very end where it's all dry, it's all ready to go. Then I'll take like a gold pen or something, silver pen, and kind of just accentuate things. And sometimes I go too far with it, and this would be an example of that.
I don't know. You know what I would?
You ever overwork something, Brandon?
If I was marketing this, I would call it the divorce lawyer.
Ooh, I like that. Yeah, you don't want that guy.
Yeah, you don't want your nightmares coming at you. The divorce lawyer.
Yeah, this particular robot is definitely.
Look at that smile. Death's grin.
He's more all bite than. He's all more bark than bite, though.
Well, you know, lawyer is a spieler.
And he's drooling, too. You can tell he's like, I want your money.
Oh, I thought he was just one of those gold teeth loosening up and falling out.
No, actually, robot skulls are very sturdy, very durable.
Are they made out of titanium?
The thing about robots is you can make them any way you want. So this particular one is made of titanium.
You could make him out of terracotta, but then he'd be very fragile.
This was not made of any regular. This is all drawn up out of my imagination.
Uh-oh.
That's all right. No, that's fine. We can move on to
Let's move on.
This is just me going a little.
This has nothing to do with robots.
No, well, kind of.
It looks like a slaughter.
It.
There's bodies and body parts lying around. It's this like Chicagoland, I'd call it.
This is like when, so when you think of Taylor Swift in her Red album, I'll get there, Your Honor.
Okay, I'm just.
Relevance.
What's the color, by the way?
I'll get there, Your Honor.
Oh, okay. Here, I'll put on the thing.
Taylor Swift in her Red album, that was a transition to pop. If you listen to the album, State of Grace, that's all country stuff. But then you get Trouble and all that stuff. Sweaty in here.
You're just not used to the hot lights.
No. So Taylor Swift had Trouble and all that. So this is my transition to like abstract. So I was going like regular.
It's Picasso-ish.
Standard things. And this is kind of like my mid in between to, you know, Picasso. Yeah, well, Picasso is a definite influence. And it's fun to, you know, honor your heroes.
It's like if it's a Picasso, like one of his characters from the teens, you know, the 19 teens.
Right.
Some, like the robot just tore it apart and left it on the floor.
Yeah.
You know, he comes to his studio in Paris and look, there's been carnage. Probably a robotic Picasso got a case of the snits.
Yeah.
And did in one of his, you know, characters.
So this is like a spaceship type of robot thing. Where you can kind of see the ladder coming down to Earth, like a landing spaceship. You can see the bottom where it would land and leave that mark. You can see the ladder getting in.
I don't know. It looks more like a Holocaust to me, like a robotic Picasso robot Holocaust.
Well, yeah, artist interpretive. It's certainly not that, though. I would definitely stamp that. But I would tell you the color. You asked about the color. The color I achieved by taking highlighter markers.
What is the color? I'm colorblind.
So it's yellow, it's green, it's pink, it's orange. Okay. All the highlighter colors, which I squeeze the juice out of the felt in the middle, and I put them in little cups. And then I'll add Flexol. I don't know, this stuff they sell at Home Depot. It's like a paint extender.
Yeah.
So you can mix it with that, make it into a paint substance. And use it for the brightest colors available, you know. So I like to use that.
Okay.
And something I've recently been getting into airbrushing, too, because, you know, you can have the look of spray paint without really committing to the blast.
Let's see your next work. Oh, I love this one.
Yeah, that one's pretty cool. It's kind of like a cocky, arrogant.
Looks like, to me, either the Sphinx or the robotic woman from Fritz Lang's 1926 silent masterpiece, Metropolis.
I haven't seen that
but
movie.
But Sphinx is definitely, I can say.
I could see that, yeah, like the pyramids, you mean?
Yeah, at the pyramids.
Yeah, you're right. So this one, absolutely interpretive. This one is just kind of, again, I went with it. And the face, it's almost like, you ain't about this life. You don't want this life. Like, I'm a robot, sure. I can pick things up, sure. But I'm dead inside. Look at me. Look at my brain. It's protruding, you know?
I would call this one Slouching Towards Babylon from the Yeats poem. Because, you know, it's bringing, this is the AI apocalypse coming towards us.
It really is. And
Riddle of the Sphinx.
It also reminds me of, like, an Atlantis water slide. Where people line up, climb up.
There is.
You can see out his chest area that looks like a water slide for the lils. But up top, you can climb all the way up, and then out his nose is a special little water slide.
So you're saying that the apocalypse failed and capitalism has vulgarized this great artifact?
I'm saying there's a lot of rides at Disney World and stuff that resemble this type of thing. You can kind of see a roller coaster in the shoulder region. See the carts going around and around?
I prefer to see that as superstructure of buildings that have been disintegrated.
But watch
by, like,
out.
Nuclear warfare.
Watch out for those robots at Disney World. If things go
wrong. They started at Disney
World. They could come to life. And this is an example of, you know, controlled chaos that went just way off.
Okay, let's go on. Mm. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, see the carts in the middle there? Like.
Yeah, I can.
Like a little ride.
But now I see like ancient hieroglyphics and stuff, and those huge glyphs that ancient peoples put on like hillsides and things.
Is that the zoomiest
to get? It also
reminds
me of Cuckoo Clock in a way. Oh, wow.
Yeah, so, yeah, it's kind of like, I like to make it layered. That look, again, is achieved by that epoxy. So it kind of looks like you can see dimensional, and that's yeah. The key to my work. When people buy it and they put it on the wall, they always say, like, dude, I saw something different today.
Oh, yeah.
So
I want to see this one in person.
Very detailed and very meticulous and very weird. I'd like to think of my art as very individually unique.
Okay, number 10. Here is Teddy.
Yeah, Teddy.
Looks like he's got the, if you ever see the Game of Thrones, there's a type of leprosy. It turns people into stone people with scales, like the princess of one of the pretenders.
I'm not going to pull any punches.
Has he got scabies or something? Or something gone wrong? Is this a robotic bear?
Let's just say this bear's pissed, okay?
Oh.
For good reason.
He heard about the lapsing of the copyright on Winnie the Pooh.
Little Joey had to decide. You have too many toys, Joey. Pick something.
That actually happened to
me. And I'm throwing them all out. This guy thought he was in. Had a great cuddle the night before. But then Joey's like, I don't care. Throw that out. So he was a discarded teddy bear.
How sad.
Yep. Found his way into a dumpster. And over the years,
was he in like all sorts of mush, like from discarded parts
just
of computers?
The worst. But he, luckily for him, it was in Seabrook.
Jesus, we're gonna do a show on Seabrook in a couple months.
All these
about the leaking radiation,
right? All these atomic colors in that.
Oh my God, he's a radiated bear.
He's a radiated bear, who was brought to life by another discard, a terminated. Seabrook worker at the plant. Yeah, yeah.
Probably an inspector, one of the radiation inspectors that got terminated.
Said, you can't fire me. Threw his lunchbox in the garbage, grabbed the bear as he saw it, and he said, aw, you're like me now. So he went home, worked on him, had a little to-go container of nuclear stuff. You know, when you get fired, you take a little...
Oh, yeah.
Something
little plutonium. Is that what's going
insurance
on?
Insurance policy.
At the it's either where the gonads or we'll just call it the seat of the bear is kind of like glowing.
Right. I wouldn't.
It's irradiated.
So there are no gonads on any teddy bears?
There aren't.
No.
You can they don't have anatomically correct teddy bears?
No, they don't actually because it's not appropriate. So when you get a teddy bear, it's usually for a child.
What about those dolls they use for children?
I never seen.
Are they anatomically correct?
I've only looked.
Are they people?
I've looked a few
robots?
Times, and I've never seen one that's anatomically correct.
That could be an interesting project coming up. You know.
Even Ken and Barbie, I feel like the mold is the same.
Yeah, I remember I had a G.I. Joe 60 years ago, and he had no genitals.
Yeah, it's not. It's just a safe bet to go that route. But so that's the route I went on. That
a genitalless bear. He can't reproduce.
But those shoes. Those are $300 shoes he found in the dumpster. Those are nice shoes. Those are dancing shoes.
They were for like a dwarf.
Yeah, exactly. So
vertically challenged person.
So he's got his nuclear, he's got his revenge, and I'll tell you what.
He looks like a slot machine in a way.
Tell you what, you don't wanna ever discard this guy again because shame on you.
Looks demented.
Once, shame on me twice.
Who put the? How'd he get that bullet hole right above his between his eyes?
It's not a bullet hole. It's a tear.
Oh, how sad!
And it's this original cotton stuffing, actually.
It doesn't even
through.
Look like. It doesn't look like much of the cotton stuffing's left. He's kind of like brainless.
Well, he has that, and everyone knows
he's developmentally challenged now.
Well, he's a robot too. Remember, he's brought. Yeah, he's not sane. You don't want this guy coming in your house. Don't buy him if you see him at Savers.
He's giving me the creeps. Let's move on.
But yeah, he's cute, I think.
Now, I'm not quite sure who this is. It's either June Trucciani, the alderman at large, or it's Caitlyn Jenner. Can we go to the close-up? I don't know. I don't see Caitlyn Jenner smiling all that much. But June Trucciani and Caitlyn Jenner, former Bruce Jenner, are both gold medal winners in my book.
I promise you what, is neither of those two.
It isn't.
Yeah. I don't know June well enough to paint her and, you know, show it like this. So maybe one day that would be awesome. But this is just a standard... Like, he's a happy robot. So
oh, it's a he.
It is a he.
But it looks like it has bosoms.
So,
could it be trans?
No.
Trans?
No. I don't really dabble in politics.
Can't they be trans robots?
I don't really dabble in politics when doing art. That would be political.
Being a trans robot?
You try to placate to all sides. So.
Well, our hermaphrodites are often in classical art.
I didn't know that.
Well, we will do a show on hermaphroditism and art and classical art.
But that guy.
That is a nice beard. So,
sometimes, guys do have bosom looks to them. It's not really their fault.
Oh, you mean the guys that have to wear a man's ear or the bra?
Like sometimes
your
guys.
Your pectoral muscles turn to fat.
Sometimes,
that's why I'm wearing, I'm clutching the jacket.
Can you zip that thing?
I got a little fat.
That's awesome.
I couldn't really move.
Very private
eye.
Because
my back was gone.
You look, you're a private eye writer, it looks like. An author on mystery. By the way, did you hear about the book coming out about Manchester?
Oh, what book about Manchester?
Something about a light, a lantern light. It's coming out in Manchester. It's featured at the Bookery, and it's about...
About a lantern?
About this murder that happened in the 60s, and it's based
around... You mean that girl, that young woman?
Yeah.
Oh, I remember that.
There's a book about it.
Oh, yeah, 1964, and it went to the Supreme Court,
the
right?
The lamplight or something?
He allegedly killed the young woman, but the way they got the search warrant was really underhanded.
Well, I mean...
Is it about that murder?
Yeah,
of the girl?
So. Underhanded, like... Hey,
well, let's have a nice two
can
shot.
Can I use your bathroom type of thing?
Oh, no. He picked the young woman, the girl up on the side of the road.
The policeman did?
It was a policeman?
No, you said search warrant.
Well, the police got a search warrant for his car in an underhanded fashion.
Well, my theory is get it done.
What's the book name?
Something. I can look it up. But anyway, it is a lot of buzz
about it. The lantern.
There's a buzz about it, and it's going to be featured at the Bookery.
Who wrote it?
That's a good question. I thought you would be the guy to talk to about. But I think it's cool to have but it's more than just a murder mystery, It, describes Manchester. The setting is Manchester, and it's like a national book. So it's cool to, despite the subject matter, to bring light onto Manchester is always good.
Particularly when it's murder. Is this the murder at the Manchester Museum?
I don't know. Why, is that another book?
Yes.
Perhaps. So, I guess the girl, she was walking down the street and she just got picked up?
I don't know.
Or thrown in? See, in the 60s, it's easier to get away with crime, I feel like. Right now, you can't do that. Thank God. They say it's as bad as ever right now, but it's not. The 60s, it had to be so much easier to commit crime than now because there's not a camera on every corner.
Oh, there wasn't a camera on every corner.
There's no camera. Okay, there was no camera. Either.
But,
right, but there's not many. They got it pretty well surveyed, I'd say.
Do you really think so?
I think so. I mean, you can't just break into a building.
We'll do the rest of Virat. There's only two other things, but we'll do it next time you come on.
Oh, no, let's go now.
No, we're talking about murder and stuff.
Okay.
And it was only a picture of Michael Jordan and Marilyn Monroe. We can show them quickly, but we'll show the last two. There's Michael Jordan.
Yeah, he's not really robotic.
And there's
it's not Marilyn Monroe. That's my son. So
I thought that was Marilyn Monroe.
That's a big wall piece I did. Someone's getting their garage torn
down. I thought you
down.
Saw Blonde and went out and did this. Blonde, by the way, was a terrible movie.
No, that's a child, John.
Looked like Marilyn Monroe, her big eyes, you know? She was kind of like a child.
Well, kids have big eyes, too.
Yeah, wide-eyed, but people care. You have done Marilyn Monroe in the past, so
I do a lot of
fair game that I actually thought it was Marilyn Monroe.
Do you know why I paint Marilyn Monroe?
Because she's dead? Because
low-hanging fruit. If I need a sale, I'll just bag out a quick Marilyn Monroe, a Frank Sinatra, an Elvis, and
it's
people
crazy.
Just scoop them up.
But if you look at high-end real estate, because I was going to win the lottery. I came very close, but we won't get into that.
You were going to.
You see in all the real high-end, they all have an Andy Warhol, Marilyn Monroe. It's quite boring. And, you know, they take all these great, like, townhouses and stuff in New York and the places, and they just gut them, turn them into, like, an everyday apartment with all white walls. It's just awful.
Warhol.
That Bauhaus influence.
Warhol is super popular right now. It's like.
Yeah, it's just fetishism of commodities.
And there's people, there's artists out there that literally do what he did, and they get, you know, the high-end art world is a little confusing.
We have an incoming call.